Hello friends, in this video we'll do a quick revision on climatic regions and answer a few questions from previous prelims papers. In the previous videos I've explained about all these climatic regions which come under Köppen scheme of climatic classification. So we have studied about important types under tropical humid climate, where we have equatorial rainforest climate, which is also called as tropical wet type of climate. Here there is no distinct dry season and the year-long temperatures are constant between 25 to 27 degrees Celsius. And we have tropical monsoon type of climate, where there are three distinct seasons. The first one is summer, and then we have rainy season followed by winters. So we have three seasons. In the tropical wet there is only one season, that is rainy season. And then we have tropical wet and dry type of climatic region, which is also called as savanna type of climatic region. Here there are two important seasons. The first one is summer, which is also a wet season, and then we have winter, which is totally dry. And under the dry climates there are two important types. One is semi-arid, other one is arid. Under semi-arid type we have two types, that is subtropical steppe and mid-latitude steppe. Subtropical steppe closely resembles savanna type of climatic region, whereas mid-latitude steppe is very distinct. The mid-latitude steppe region is a grassland region in the mid-latitude or temperate regions. So here again it is a semi-arid type of climate, where rainfall is between 25 to 60 or 70 centimeters per annum. And we have the desert type of climatic regions, which are also dry climatic regions. So there are two important types. One is subtropical deserts, which are also called as hot deserts, and we have mid-latitude deserts, which are called as cold deserts. And in the temperate regions we have four important types. The first one is called as humid subtropical. It is also known as China type or Gulf type or Natal type of climatic region, based on regional variations. Here there is no distinct dry season and the winters are warm and the maximum rainfall occurs in winter. So here we can see, even if there is a short dry season, it is of very short duration. And in the China type there is a pronounced monsoon characteristics, and it is called as temperate monsoon type of climatic conditions. And in the Gulf type the monsoon type of characteristics are not well pronounced, whereas in the Natal type the monsoon characteristics are totally absent. And then we have Mediterranean type of climate, which is also called as temperate west coast climate. Here the summers are dry whereas winters are wet, but the rainfall, the quantum of rainfall per annum is quite low. And then we have marine west coast climate, which is the most favorable climate for maximum human output. It is also called as British type climate. Here the maximum rainfall occurs during winters and the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year. So in the British type of climatic region we have rainfall mainly due to westerlies, which bring rainfall in the form of frontal cyclones. Even in the Mediterranean type of climate, summers are warm summers are dry because of the subtropical high pressure belt, which doesn't facilitate cloud formation, and winters are wet mainly because of the westerly winds. And then we have the fourth type in the temperate regions, which is called as humid continental. It is included under cold snow forest type of climatic regions. Under humid continental, which is also called as Laurentian type of climatic regions, we have a climatic condition where the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year and the winters are quite severe compared to the other type of temperate regions. And the next one under cold snow forest type of climates is the subarctic type of climatic region, which is also called as taiga type of climatic region. Here the winters are quite dry and the average annual rainfall is quite low. And then we have the tundra type, which is where the ground is totally covered by snow. And then we have polar ice cap, where the ground is covered by few hundred meters thick ice caps. And then we have highland climate, which closely resembles the tundra type of climatic regions. So this is the equatorial rainforest type of climatic region. We have selvas of Amazon, and then we have parts of Congo and surrounding regions in Africa, and then we have certain parts of Southeast Asia. So all these regions come under equatorial rainforest type of climatic region. And then we have savanna type of climatic region, which is also called as wet and dry type of climatic region. So certain grasslands like llanos and then campos, and we have Kano grasslands, which are a transition zone between the Sahara Desert and the equatorial rainforest type of climatic region. And then we have other savanna grassland regions which are present in northern part of Australia. And then we have monsoon type of climate. We have seen there are three distinct seasons: summer, rainy and winter. So India, Southeast Asia see this type of climatic region along with northern parts of Australia. And there is a slight variation called as tropical marine type of climatic region. And these certain islands like Madagascar and regions of eastern Africa, parts of eastern South America, and parts of North and South America, the region between North and South America, all these parts comes under tropical marine type of climatic regions. The major difference between tropical monsoon and tropical marine is that the rainfall is quite well distributed throughout the year in the tropical marine type of climate, whereas there is a distinct dry season in the tropical monsoon type of climatic region. Then we have dry climatic conditions, and we have deserts, which are mainly formed due to subtropical high pressure belts. Along with that, we have cold currents, which are bordering these particular regions. So all these conditions have created deserts in various parts of the world, especially near tropics. And we have semi-arid climate. These are transition zones between various dry and wet type of climatic regions. And then we have cold semi-arid type of climates, which are found mainly in the highland regions like tall mountains and various temperate regions like the steppe grasslands, etc. And then we have temperate grasslands, which are also called as steppe grasslands. So we have prairies of North America and pampas of South America, welds, that is high weld and low weld in the parts of South Africa. And then we have downs, which are part of Australia. And then we have Canterbury Plains, which are a part of New Zealand. And then we have pustas, which are called as the steppe grasslands in the Western European region. They are called as pustas. And then we have Asiatic steppes, which are a part of Kazakhstan and then Mongolia and various other regions. And then we have Mediterranean type of climate, which is found on the west coast in the subtropical region. So northern parts of Africa, southern parts of Europe, parts of California, the region surrounding San Francisco, and then we have central Chile and western Australia and Swanland of Australia. All these regions come under Mediterranean type of climatic regions. So in winters, these regions come under the influence of westerlies. As a result, they are wet in winter, whereas in summer, they are under the influence of subtropical high pressure belt. Hence, they are very dry in summer climatic conditions. And then we have temperate eastern margin climate, which is also called as China type of climate. So there are three regional variations. One is China, other one is Gulf type and Natal type. So China type has a distinct monsoonal characteristics. And the monsoonal characteristics in Gulf type are less pronounced, whereas in Natal type, the monsoonal characteristics are totally absent. So the rainfall is well distributed in all these type of climatic regions. And then we have British type of climatic regions, which is the most favored climatic regions for human survival. So here we have regions of United Kingdom, Germany, France, and certain parts of Southern Australia, Tasmania, and New Zealand, along with that certain parts of Chile, etc. All these regions, along with British Columbia, comes under British type of climatic regions. And then we have Laurentian type of climatic region, which is also called as temperate eastern margin climate. There are two variations. One is North American variation, other one is Asiatic type. So there are quite differences between these type of climatic regions. Few common characteristics are that summers are very warm and winters are very cold. And most of these regions have rich soft and hardwood trees, and they are very useful from the economic perspective. And then we have taiga type of climate, which is a dense coniferous forest regions. So this huge stretch of landmass, which is a part of Russia, and then we have huge stretch of landmass, which is a part of Canada. So all these parts come under taiga type of climatic regions. And we have tundra type, which have extreme cold climatic regions. They border taiga type of climatic regions. So now let us look at few questions based on our understanding of climatic regions. The graph below shows the mean average monthly temperatures and mean average rainfalls. So identify the region. So here are four options: wet and dry type of climatic region, dry tropical, semi-arid tropical, and temperate marine. So if our basics are clear, these type of questions are very easy, and these types of questions are asked almost every year, so it is important to understand these graph based questions which come under climatic regions. So now let us look at one by one. So we have wet and dry tropical type of climate, which is also called as savanna type of climate. So if you look at the graph, we have rainfall which is around 10 centimeters average per annum, 10 centimeters average per month, so which would amount to about 120 centimeters per annum. Here, if you see that, the rainfall is well distributed. It has summer maxima, whereas in the months of June and August, it has minimum amount of rainfall. But still, it is above 6 centimeters per month. So in the wet and dry type of climate, at least 1 month has rainfall lesser than 6 centimeters. And here, the winters are totally dry and summers are wet. But if you look at this particular graph, the winters have good amount of rainfall. So this particular option is wrong. And then we have rainy tropical. We know that in rainy tropical, the rainfall, the quantum of annual rainfall is around 150 centimeters. So if you look at the graph, it has about 120 to 130 centimeters per annum, which is close to 150. And if you look at the temperature, annual average temperature is about 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. And we know that in the rainforest region, the temperature is always above average. Monthly temperature is always above 18 degrees Celsius and is somewhere around 27 degrees Celsius. So this also closely fits under description of rainy tropical type of or equatorial rainforest type of climatic regions. And then we have semi-arid tropical. We know that in semi-arid tropical, the rainfall, the average annual rainfall is less than 65 centimeters. So here we have average rainfall, which is quite higher than 100 centimeters. So this option is also clearly wrong. So these two options are clearly wrong. And then we have temperate marine type of climate. So temperate marine type is nothing but the British type of climatic region. And we know that in the British type of climatic region, the temperature is not very warm. So it doesn't have, usually doesn't have temperatures about 20 degrees Celsius. But if you look at the graph here, most of the months have temperatures about 20 degrees Celsius. So again, this particular answer is also wrong. So the clear option is tropical rainy type of or equatorial rainforest type of climatic region, option B. Of the four shaded areas in the map, which is characterized by hot, dry summers, so the important term is hot, dry summers, mild and moist winters, and seasonal reversal of winds. So we can see various important terms here. Hot, dry summers, which is a characteristic feature of Mediterranean type of climatic regions. And then we have mild moist winters, which is also typical to Mediterranean type of climatic regions. Another important term is seasonal reversal of winds. Now let us look which of these places come under this particular type of climatic conditions. We have San Francisco region and regions bordering California, and then we have certain parts of Southeastern America, and then we have regions close to natal type of climatic regions, and then we have southern parts of Australia. So if you look at these particular regions, option B, that is region 2, this particular region comes under the natal type of climatic conditions. So we know that in natal type of climatic conditions, there is no distinct dry season, so this can be totally ruled out. And then we have 3, it is closely, this particular climatic region is distributed among natal type, and we have tropical marine type to the north. So if you consider this whole region, it also has good amount of rainfall throughout the year and there is no distinct dry season. So both 2 and 3 can be ruled out. And then we have Southern Australian climate. Here we have the Swanland region and the western parts of Australia, which come under Mediterranean type of climate, and southern parts of Australia, which come under the British type of climatic regions. And we have San Francisco region, which comes under Mediterranean type of climatic conditions. So here again, if we look at the key factor, that is seasonal reversal of winds. So these two regions comes under Mediterranean type of climatic regions, but there is no seasonal reversal of winds when it comes to the region of Southern Australia. But this particular type of seasonal reversal occurs in the regions of San Francisco. So the answer is 1. Again, look at the graph and answer the questions. We have 4 types: China type, equatorial type, hot desert type, and monsoonal type. So now let us consider the most easiest ones. So we have hot desert type. We know that in the hot desert type, the rainfall is below, the average annual rainfall is below 20 centimeters, 25 centimeters. So if you look at here, even a single month has about 15 centimeters annual average monthly rainfall. So we can totally rule out this particular option because this particular region has well distributed rainfall throughout the year. So option C is wrong. Coming to monsoon type of climatic region has rainfall only in summer months, that is post summer months, that is during June, July, August, and September. Whereas in the winter months, the region is totally dry. In both extreme summer as winter, as well as winter, the region is totally dry. But if you look at this particular climatic region, we have extreme summers, that is May, April and March. So here the average rainfall is above 6 centimeters. So we can say this as wet climatic condition. And hence monsoon type of climatic regions can also be ruled out. And if you consider China type, we know that in China type, the summers are warm and winters are mild. And also the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year. So if you consider the China type, we can see the temperatures are quite low during winter months and quite high during summer months, and the rainfall is well distributed with the summer maximum. Now compare the other option, equatorial type. We know that in equatorial type, the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year. We can see one of this rainfall favoring this particular description. But here we have certain months like November, December and Jan, which have rainfall below 6 centimeters. Remember that in equatorial regions, not more than 1 month has rainfall below 6 centimeters. So here the answer will be clearly China type. Along with that, we have one more clue in terms of temperature. We know that in the equatorial type, the temperature is never below annual daily temperature is never below 18 degrees Celsius. But here we can see certain months where the temperature falls below 18 degrees Celsius. So again, all these three options are wrong. The China type is the most fitting description. So we have four climatic regions: St. Lawrence type, China type, Western European type and Mediterranean type. Again, now we have to pick the most easiest and clearly distinguishable climatic region. Here the most clearly distinguishable climatic region is Mediterranean type of climatic region, where summers are totally dry whereas winters are mildly wet. So if you look at this climatic graph, this particular region has very well distributed rainfall throughout the year. As a result, this can be totally ruled out. And then we have Western European type of climatic region, where the temperature is quite moderate. There is no extreme of temperature. That is, the temperature doesn't go below freezing or it is not very warm during summers. And the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year with winter maxima. This is because of westerlies. So if you consider this option, we can see maximum temperature occurs in the May, June, July months, and hence this particular region is in the northern hemisphere. So in the northern hemisphere, summer occurs in May, June, July. So we can say that this particular region comes under northern hemisphere, and in summer this particular region has less rainfall, whereas in winters it has maximum rainfall. We know that this is a peculiar characteristic of British type of climate, where winters have maximum rainfall because of westerlies. So the most favorable option is C. So let us consider other two options as well. In the China type of climate, we have summers which have maximum rainfall. We can see this particular region, because of highest temperatures in these months, comes under northern hemisphere. So we can say that this particular months have rainfall during summers. We can see these particular months have rainfall lesser than the other months. So in the China type, we have summer maxima, but in the option we have winter maxima. So this particular option can be ruled out. In the St. Lawrence type of climatic region, we have very hot summers and very cold winters. But here we can see the climatic condition is not too extreme. That is, summers are not too hot and winters are not too cold. So again, this particular option can be ruled out. Along with that, Laurentian type has rainfall, maximum rainfall, which occurs in summer months. So with all these factors, we can say that Western European type or British type of climatic region is the ones that fit this particular description. So we have again four options: the Mediterranean region, monsoon, steppe and Northwest European region, which is also called as British type of climatic region. Here it is given that average temperature is about 12.8 degrees Celsius and average rainfall is about 54.9 centimeters per annum. So here certain options can be easily ruled out. For example, we have monsoon region, which have average annual rainfall about 200 to 250 centimeters. So here this particular option can be clearly ruled out. And then we have the steppe region, where we have rainfall about 25 to 60 centimeters, so it is still a possibility. And then we have Northwestern European region, which is also called as British type of climatic region. We know that in the British type of climatic regions, the rainfall is well distributed throughout the year and the rainfall is around 100 centimeters per annum. But if you look at this particular rainfall chart, we have summer months which have no rainfall at all. So these particular months have very less or negligible rainfall, and hence this particular option can be ruled out. And then we have steppe region. Steppe region has rainfall where an average annual might vary between 60 to 25 centimeters. And here we can see that in summers there is no, summers are totally dry, whereas in steppe region maximum rainfall occurs in summers and winters are somewhat dry. So from this particular observation we can rule out steppe region as well, and clearly Mediterranean region is the remaining option. And we know that in the northern hemisphere, in the Mediterranean type of climatic regions, that is in summer we have very dry climatic conditions, whereas in winters we have certain amount of rainfall. So this is a clearly Mediterranean region climatic conditions. Consider the following statements. In equatorial regions, the year is divided into four main seasons. In Mediterranean region, summer months receive more rain. And then in China type of climate, we have rainfall that occurs throughout the year. And then we have tropical highlands exhibit vertical zonation of different climates. So here vertical zonation is nothing but variation of natural vegetation based on altitude. For example, at the ground level, we have equatorial rainforests are similar type of climatic region. And with increasing height, the equatorial rainforests are replaced by tropical deciduous or moist deciduous type of forests. And then these particular forests are replaced by coniferous at certain heights. And after that, we have snow line where there is no forest. This particular region is completely covered by snow line. So from these options, we can say that option 4 is clearly correct, because highlands exhibit vertical zonation of different climates. So if you look at options, this particular option has no 4. And if you look at other easy options, in the equatorial regions, the year is divided into 4 main seasons. And remember that in the tropical monsoon type of climatic region, we have 3 different seasons, that is summer, rainy and winter. And in the tropical wet and dry, that is savanna type of climate, there are 2 seasons, one is summer, other one is winter. And in the equatorial rainforest type of climate, we have only 1 season, which is rainy season. So this option is clearly wrong. And again, 4 main seasons, this is a typical feature of British type of climatic region and other temperate regions which have distinct 4 seasons, that is summer, spring, winter and autumn. So this particular feature is a characteristic of temperate regions and not equatorial regions. So option wise is totally false. So if you see, all these options can be ruled out clearly. So the final answer would be 3 and 4. So if you check other options as well, in Mediterranean region, summer months receive more rain. We know that Mediterranean region has winter maxima, that is most of the rainfall occurs in winter and summers are totally dry. So this particular option is wrong. In China type of climate, rainfall occurs throughout the year. So this particular option is correct. So 3 and 4 is the answer. Climate is extreme, rainfall is scanty, and the people used to be nomadic herders. The above statement best describes which of the following region. Now let us consider each of these regions. The first one is African savanna. We know that in African savanna, climate is extreme. Climate is extreme in summers, where summers are very warm, whereas winters are somewhat mild and very dry. And the rainfall is scanty, but this particular description doesn't fit into African savanna, because in African savanna we have rainfall that occurs in summer and it is between 100 to 150 centimeters. So 100 to 150 centimeters is a very good amount of rainfall, so you cannot consider this as scanty. So option 1 is false. And if you look at other option, like people used to be nomadic herders, and there are 2 types of occupations. One is settled agricultural farmers, like in the Nigerian region, and we have nomadic herders which command in the regions of Eastern Africa. So we have both the type of occupations, and hence all these options doesn't fit in the African savanna type of climatic region. And let us look at other possible options. Central Asian steppes. Here we have climates which are extreme, that is summers are very warm and winters are very cold. Rainfall is scanty. We know that here the rainfall is about 25 to 60 centimeters. So this is considered scanty or semi-arid type of climatic condition. So both these descriptions fit Central Asian steppe. And then people used to be nomadic herders. Here again you can consider this as 2 ways. Used to be nomadic herders, or you can consider them as presently nomadic herders. We know that there are certain regions like Kyrgyz, Kazakhstan and certain parts of Mongolia. All these regions used to be nomadic herders. The main occupation used to be pastoralists, where they were nomadic herders. That is, they moved from region to region to graze their cattle. And in the modern times, under the communist regimes, they were forced to settle down and become settled cultivators. So we can say there are 2 options. you can say in two terms, that is used to be and presently not. So under certain these descriptions, this particular climatic region fits well. And then we have North American prairie, and North American prairie historically had been a dry land, but with the mechanization of agricultural activity, this particular region has now turned into granaries of the world. So there was no nomadic herders any time in the history. And if you look at other options like extreme, it suits, and even scanty rainfall, this also fits in the North American prairie type of climatic region. And we have Siberian tundra. Here we have extreme climatic conditions and the rainfall is scanty. And when it comes to nomadic herders, here the persons are not nomadic herders, that is, they don't graze their animals, so they are not herders. They are nomadic, but still they follow a nomadic life where they go for hunting fishes, bears, and various other tundra animals. So here there are no herders, that is, the ones that graze cattle or sheep. So these particular options are totally false, and the best fitting option is Central Asian steppe. The seasonal reversal of winds in the is the typical characteristic of, so this is a very easy answer, easy question, monsoon type. So monsoon type is the only region along with the China type which has seasonal reversal of winds during various seasons. Match list 1 and list 2 and select the correct answer. So we have certain types of trees and we have certain types of regions. So based on their climatic conditions, we need to come at a conclusion about which particular tree fits in the certain region. Now let us look at each tree. The most familiar one is the teak. For us, we know that teak occurs in both India as well as Myanmar, but Myanmar is the one that leads in the cultivation or production of teak. And we know that the Irrawaddy River of Myanmar is used for transportation of teak logs from the northern parts of Myanmar to the Rangoon sawmills. So we can easily arrive at a conclusion about teak. So D will match with 1. So we have two options, B and C. So we can rule out A and D. And then we have mahogany, one more tree of the equatorial region. It is found in both equatorial rainforest as well as tropical deciduous types of forest regions, but it is most common in the equatorial rainforest region and temperate tropical marine type of forest regions. And if we see all these regions, we have Canada, which comes under mostly temperate regions. All of it comes under temperate regions. And we have Mexico, which is a subtropical climatic region, and very little part of it is in the very close to the tropics. And we have Honduras. Honduras is the region between very close to Panama, which is between North America and South America. So this particular region comes under tropical marine type of climatic region, which closely resembles equatorial rainforest type of climatic region. So we can equate 3 with 4. So both the options as 4. So again, we are locked with B and C. Now next two options, cedar and Douglas fir. We know that cedar is very common in the taiga type of climatic regions, and we know that taiga type of climatic region occurs mostly in Canada, and we also know that fir also occurs in Canada. So this is a type of tricky question here, because we have both the options which closely fit the region of taiga climatic conditions. But if you look at cedar is occurs only in Canada, whereas Mexico is a subtropical country. So we can come to a conclusion that cedar is most typical to Canada. So if you look at A, it is matched with 2. So we have option C, which fits into the description. So the final answer is C. Coming to the Douglas fir is a type of a tree which occurs in both subtropical as well as taiga type of climatic conditions. So this particular tree occurs in both Mexico as well as Canada. So if you look at this particular map, which gives information about various types of trees that are found in different forest climatic regions. So for example, in India, we have India and Myanmar, we have teak, ebony, oak, silver fir, spruce, etc. Whereas in the Canadian taiga type of forest regions, we have cedar, Douglas fir, pines, spruce, etc. And in the Mexican forests, we have Douglas fir and pines. So we can see certain trees are common for both tropical as well as temperate regions. For such trees are Douglas fir, pine, etc. So we can try to understand this particular location of various trees, tree types that occur in various forests to answer various questions that can be asked in prelims papers. So this is all about climatic regions and certain questions that were asked in the previous prelims papers. Hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.